Good evening, friends. We start tonight with the new revelations from the Panama Papers. The massive document leak shows now over 200 Americans use services of the Panamanian law firm Mossack Fonseca. Some seem to be pretty innocent, such as retirees buying real estate in Central America. But others are businessmen charged or convicted of serious financial crimes. The federal government says it will use the Panama Papers to help prosecute financial criminals. So far, the documents haven't revealed the names of any American politicians or anybody running for office. Transparency advocates are now calling for the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists to release the Panamanian Papers in full. For more on this, let's turn to America's lawyer and Ring of Fire radio host Mike Papantonio. Well, Mike, good to have you with us tonight. It looks like we're dealing with the elite, the global fraternity of tax dodgers and cheats. I mean, how else do you call it? Okay, now that the Department of Justice has got the names of 200 Americans, what do they do? What's their next move?
Well, what you have is legally sanctioned tax evasion for millionaires. This is not tax avoidance. This is clearly tax evasion. The DOJ, they didn't even prosecute the easy drop-dead cases on Wall Street where we had incredible conduct of Wall Street where they stole so much from mom and pop. Here's what DOJ is going to be looking for: low-hanging fruit. They're not going to go after millionaires to show that they're not paying taxes, even though the U.S. is losing about $150 billion a year to
thing. I mean, there's no way the Department of Justice can let this slide in any stretch of imagination when we've got this big political debate in this country about what we're going to do about people who park money offshore. I mean, we got to take the lead on this, don't we?
Ed, they won't do anything creative. They're afraid to lose. That's why they didn't prosecute Wall Street. You'll see them going after drug traffickers or people that it's just clear that the money is somehow being laundered. But where it comes to the billionaire or the millionaire who's simply putting it in this, you know, using this as a scam so they don't have to pay taxes, there's ways they can go after them. Even though this is legally sanctioned, there are ways they can go after them. But you watch, this is Department of Justice that'll sit on their hands. This will pass. The millionaires will get away. The guy on the street who doesn't pay his taxes, he's going to prison.
Well, some interesting names on there. David Geffen. David Geffen is a big Democratic donor and has been for years. What do you make of that?
Well, don't forget, I mean, you know, this is something that was pushed by Hillary Clinton. She thought this Panama deal was a great idea. It was a trade agreement. It was an Obama trade agreement that was going to be good and somehow for trade. I never quite got that. But even when it was discussed back then, it was people like the millionaire class, like Geffen, who really understood this was going to be a way to hide money.
Yeah.
And so that's what he's done. It's not just Geffen. There's about a half a dozen other millionaire, billionaire types that will get away with it. They won't be prosecuted because it is legally sanctioned tax evasion.
All right. Mike Papantonio with us tonight. Thanks, Mike. Appreciate it so much.